still a series of war in the eastern part of Ukraine. And we decided that this is the time to do our services in Ukrainian. And we have a team of those who translated from Hebrew into Ukrainian. So you will hear the flow of Ukrainian language amongst the Slavic languages. Ukrainian is like Italian among the Roman German languages. So let us start, Rabbi Matt, please. So we have on our screen, I understand that you're trying to do yours, but for those who are here, it's better to use our slides. So our technicians, can you start? Roma? Матову, давайте.
So, would you like me to start or wait? Oh, yes, it is.
Start and then, oh yes, it's here.
Wonderful. Matovu ohaleha yako Mishkenoteha Yisrael. Atovu ohaleha Yaakov Mishkenoteha Yisrael. Vani v'rohaseha Avo v'etecha Eshaha
Які прекрасні шатра твої, Якове, оселі твої, Ізраїлю. How beautiful are your tents, O Israel. And possibly the beauty of our tents is because we are united, because we are together. And 7 hours and nearly 10,000 kilometers or 7,000 miles doesn't separate us. I would like to introduce a young cantorial soloist, both of them. One is training to be the lawyer, but he graduated from the music school. And another, Anna, she is only 17. She is training at the music academy in Kyiv. So you will hear their voices, guitar, and the voice of Anna. They will sing Yedid Nefesh.
Yeah.
in our London department, my late wife had a fridge magnet, and it was written that a friend is a person who knows you well, who accepts you as you are, and gently pushes you to be better. And the words which just were sang is about friend of our soul. It's about God who wants us to be better. And when we are become better, then we can have an anthem which was written by King David, Psalm 150. And I would like to ask Rabbi Matthew to lead us in singing of Alleluia.
Thank you so much. Alleluia, 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 Kol Hanshama, Alleluia, 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 Kol Hanshama. Shama te haleluya, 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 hola shama te haleluya, haleluya, haleluya. May everything that breathes praise God, hallelujah.
Before we will lead the Shabbos candle, I would like to give a floor to past president of our congregation, because the active president recently made Aliyah to Israel. So we have a member of the board and the past president of our congregation, Jana Burgina. And you will see, she will speak in Ukrainian, but on the screen, you will see her speech in English.
Шановні рабини, члени рад та всі наші друзі з громад Темпель Шалом і Темпель Ахават Шалом. Я Жанна Бургіна, член правління та колишня голова громади прогресивного юдаїзму Хатіква в місті Київ, столиці України. Від імені своєї громади я хотіла би подякувати вам за вашу духовну щедрість, за велику та неоцінену роль, яку ваші громади відіграють у зміцненні цінностей тефельмийського іудаїзму та у посиленні його присутності в Україні. Завдяки вашим внескам протягом останніх років не лише понад 20 дітей обідали 40 тижнів у нашій сімейній школі, також ваша фінансова підтримка дозволило нам провести 3 пасхальні седери для більше 100 учасників кожен. Крім того, ваші внески до персонального фонду рабина духовного дозволили рабину допомогти пенсіонерам та тим членам нашої громади, які потребували матеріальної допомоги. Я хотіла би підкреслити важливу роль, яку Джуді Палей та її покійний чоловік Говард з Темпель Шалом відіграли в започаткуванні та розвитку нашої дружби. Спасибо. Також ми вдячні Едварду Марксу, який багато років знає громаду Хатіква і привернув увагу своєї громади до потреб реформістської громади в Києві. Я не буду забирати багато вашого часу, однак хочу наголосити, що економічна ситуація в Україні нестабільна, на що також впливає пандемія COVID-19. Середня пенсія становить $120, Середня зарплата – $300. Життя в Україні дорожче, ніж в Європі чи у вашій країні. Хабад в нашій країні є впливовим і применшує наші реформаторські цінності, поширюючи чутки про те, що реформісти є християнами. Саме тому наша дружба така важлива. Урок, який ми засвоїли з цього, і який породжений вашою щедрістю, це відчуття єдності великої єврейської родини, величі ваших сердець і відкритості ваших душ. Відносини з усіма вами і з вашими громадами для нас безцінні, допомагаючи нам продовжувати розбудовувати сильний єврейський реформістський рух у Києві та по всій Україні. Ми будемо продовжувати розвивати наші громади і реформістський рух, який поширює цінності іудаїзму і підкреслює прагнення України та всіх її громадян до свободи, людських цінностей, гідності, толерантності, інклюзивності та миру. Нехай же всі ми будемо здорові і зможемо продовжити нашу роботу зі зміцнення нашої живої реформи іудаїзму по всій планеті. Спасибі вам за допомогу, співчуття, за ваші думки та дружбу. Ми з нетерпінням чекаємо вашого приїзду до України, який зробить нашу дружбу ще міцнішою і відкриє нові можливості для ваших зв'язків. Дякую за увагу.
Дякую. And now is the time to lead the Shabbat candles, and I would like to invite the Haidar family to do so. Alexander Gaidar is executive director of the Religious Union for Progressive Jewish Congregations of Ukraine, and his wife Alexandra Gaidar is a member of the board of the Hatikva and also a past president of the Hatikva congregation. Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom to all of you. So you will start Shabbat quite early, but Shabbat brings additional soul. So just enjoy with a smile what you have and what God gives us together with Shabbat. And now I would like to introduce our cantorial soloist who came to our congregation together with his parents when he was only 11. Now he is a prominent businessman and also a composer. He writes liturgical music. This is Michael Urisman. You will hear a few melodies which was written by our cantorial soloist, and now is one of these melodies. This is the anthem to Shabbat, Lecha Dodi, the melody which was written by Michael Urisman.
Shabbat
Uplifting Shabbat, Shabbat ne Kabbalah. Lecha Adoni, likrat Kabbalah. Pnei Shabbat, Shabbat ne Kabbalah. Psalm 92 ends with the words of righteousness. And we know that not only Jewish people can be righteous. This week, when we commemorate the 80th anniversary of Babi Yar tragedy, we also celebrate the life of those people who saved life of Jewish people. They are also righteous. And this is why the psalm of the Shabbos day ends with the words of righteous people. And I would like to ask Rabbi Matthew to lead us in the final words of this psalm, Tzadik Katamar.
Was this something that Rabbi Adam Miller, that your cantor was going to lead?
Yes, I was going to, yes.
Okay. Sorry, Donna, I didn't know because, thank you.
That's okay.
Thank you for joining us.
You're welcome. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Tzadik HaTamar Yifrach Ke'edes bavanon yiske shiturim beveit Adonai bechatzrot Eloheinu yafrichu od yenuvun Beseva Deshenim Verananim Lehagir Ki Ashar Adonai Tzuri Tzuri Velo Avlat Abo.
Thank you, Donna, because this is a tribute to Louis Lewandowski, who nearly 170 years ago wrote this liturgical music to glorify the deeds of the righteous people. And today, when we celebrate International Deaf Music, which we congratulate you, Donna, with, we are going back to the beginning of the liturgical reform music, which was sang in the early reform temples. And now Rabbi Adam Miller will lead us to the call of Baruch Hu.
So as we've all learned through this time of Zoom, and thank you, Rabbi Duchovny. It is a joy and pleasure to be sharing the Shabbat of Unity with you, with Rabbi Berger, my classmate, and with our congregations all linked together. as we think about this, we've learned over this last year and a half of the pandemic that when it comes to our electronic services, that while we are accustomed to standing often when we are in person, we can rise in spirit as well as standing physically. So I invite everyone to rise in spirit, even if you're not necessarily comfortable rising in prayer, as we now join together in the words of the Baruch Hu, our call to worship on this Sabbath day.
Let me translate into Ukrainian.
Sure.
Just a second. Рабай Міллер сказав, що коли ми ведемо наше служіння в електронному виді, не завжди вигляді, не завжди людина може встати. Тому він пропонує тим, хто в зумі не може встати, підняти свій дух. І це теж буде для того, щоб встати в нашому молінні. Тому прошу, ви можете встати, хто тут, а ті, хто в зумі, можуть підняти свій дух. Прошу. Please, Rabbi. Yes.
Baruch Hu et Adonai HaMevorach.
Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Leolam Vaed. Please be seated. The two blessings precede leading readings of Shema, and the first blessing, Na'ariv, ends with the words Baruch Ata Adonai HaMa'ariv Aravim. Let us say Amen. And the second blessing musically will be led by another cantorial soloist, David Achtirsky, please. Us in Shema prayer.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem, Kivod Malchuto, Le'olam Vaed. Would you like me to continue with the V'ahavta?
Yes, yes.
Okay. V'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavecha u'v'chol nafshecha u'v'chol me'odecha v'hayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha hayom al levavecha v'shinantam levanecha v'dibarta bam v'shivtecha b'veitecha uv'lechtecha v'aderech uv'shochbecha uv'kumecha uk'shartam le'ot al yadecha v'hayu l'totafot b'in einecha uchtavtam al mezuzot b'itecha uv'ish'arecha leman tizkeru v'asitem et kol mitzvotai v'hitem kedoshim le'elohechem ani Adonai Elohechem, Asher Hotzeiti Etchem, Me'eretz Mitzrayim, Liot Lachem Le'elohim, Ani Adonai Elohechem, Adonai Elohechem Emet.
Thank you, Donna. And two blessings are following the reading of Shema. The first blessing, Geulah, is ending with the words, "Who is like you, O God? Mi chamocha." And now again, you will hear our young cantorial soloist, Leo and Anna. Mi chamocha. Thank you, Leo and Anna. And the second blessing after reading the Shema, Hashkiveinu. And again, you will hear the melody, which was written by Michael Uisman. I love this melody. Rosalino,
שלומך ותקנני בעץ הטובה מי לפניך מי לפניך בקושי
This second blessing ends with words V'fros aleinu sukat shlamecha Baruch ata Adonai Chaperes sukat shalom aleinu V'al kol amo Yisrael V'al Yerushalayim Let us say Amen. And now we will sing the words from Shmot that the sons and the daughters of Israel will celebrate Shabbat V'shamru.
Vishamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam. Vishamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam. Bein yuvein b'nei Yisrael, oti le'olam, oti le'olam. V'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat, lasot et ha-shabbat, ledorotam berit olam. Ki sheshet yamim asaronai, Asarnai et ha-shamayim ve-et ha-aretz v'shamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam. U'vayom ha-shvi shavot v'inafash shavot v'inafash Shabbat vayinafash v'shamru v'nei Yisrael et ha-shabbat lasot et ha-shabbat ledorotam berit olam.
And Chetzi Kaddish separates the Shema prayer and the Amidah prayer. And I would like to ask Rabbi Adam Miller to lead us in Chetzi Kaddish.
Yekada v'yekada shmei rabba V'yamadi rachi rute v'yamlich malchute V'chayechonu v'yomechon U'vchayedechu beit Yisrael Bagala, bagala Uvis mankari, rimeru, amen. V'yitzadar, v'yitzaleh, v'yitzalau, Shemei dekudusha, b'richu, Leila min kol b'rchata v'shirata, Tush b'chata v'nechemata, Damiran b'alma, v'imeru,
And I like, Rabbi, your words that we are arising in spirit, and those who are able to please stand up and who are are not able, please raise your spirit. We will hear the call to Amida prayer. You will hear the Eastern, Middle Eastern melody, which will be sang by our cantorial soloist David. And then you will hear in Ukrainian language seven blessings of Amida, which are united together.
Adonai Sefatai Tiftach Ufi Yagid Ufi Yagid Echilatecha Adonai Sefatai Tiftach Ufi Yagid Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi yagid ufi yagid Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi yagid
Благословений Господь Бог наш, Бог наших прабатьків та праматерів, Бог Авраама, Бог Ісака, Бог Якова, Бог Сари, Бог Рівки, Бог Леї та Бог Рахелі, Бог Великий, Могутній і Грізний. Благословений Всевишній, який створив небо і землю, Словом Своїм Він захищав наших прабатьків, Словом Його живе все, що існує. Він, Господь, не має подібного до Господа. Він дарує спокій народу своєму в день Шабату. Служимо ж йому благовійно і трепетно, щодня і повсякчас. Будемо дякувати йому, славити ім'я його. Господи благословенний, владика, що дарує мир у пам'ять про створення Всесвіту. Він освячує Шабат, благословляє день сьомий і дарує блаженний спокій народу своєму. Хай буде відпочинок наш до вподобі тобі, Господи. Боже наш, Бог прабатьків наших, освяти нас своїми заповідями, дай долучитися до вчення Твого, подаруй нам щедро милості Твої і дай пізнати радість дарованого Тобою спасіння. Очисти серця наші для служіння Тобі в істині. Даруй нам, Господи, прихильно і з любов'ю святий день шабатній, щоб весь Ізраїль перебував цього дня в спокій, прославляючи ім'я Твоє, благословений Господь, який освятив Шабат. Барухата Дунай, Мекадеш Хашабат. І скажемо амінь. Сідайте, будь ласка. Please be seated, and this is a time for our personal, private prayer. And as a prelude to our personal prayer, I would like to read a quote. The biggest difference between money and time. You always know how much money you have, but you never know how much time you have. Як прелюдія до нашої персональної молитви, хочу поділитися цитатою, що є різниця між грошима і часом. Ми всі знаємо, скільки у нас є грошей, але ми не знаємо, скільки у нас є часу. Тому будемо ставитися з розумінням до того, що у нас є наша персональна молитва. Announcement to our Shabbat of Unity, I recall the words of Leo Beck Rabbinic School, which is located in London, from which I am graduated 23 years ago. And I said to the congregation here in Kyiv, but not only to Kyiv congregation, because with us we have other Reform congregations from all over Ukraine. We have members of Cherkasy, it's middle of Ukraine. We have from Western Ukraine, Lviv and Uzhgorod. So I recall the words that people are coming to synagogue for entertainment, and entertainment is a sermon. I do not agree that always a sermon is entertainment. But when I did the announcement, I said, please join us, because first of all, you will hear a professional cantor, Donna Azu. You will hear four cantorial soloists from Hatikva. You will hear a singing rabbi, Matt Berger, from Temple Ahavat Shalom, and you will hear three sermons in one service. So this is a time for three sermons. And I would like to ask Rabbi Matthew Berger from Temple Ahavat Shalom to start.
Shabbat Shalom to all of you in Kyiv, as well as those gathered in Naples, Florida, and around where I'm at in Palm Harbor in the Tampa area in Florida. It really is a blessing to take part in this service of unity. When I think back to when I was a child, a gathering like this would have been unthinkable, but now we can see and connect with one another across continents, which is simply amazing. On this Shabbat, we celebrate creation, Bereshit. We return to the foundational stories of the book of Genesis, and every year we strive to find new meanings in our sacred text. Following the advice of Ben Bagbag, who said, turn Torah and turn it again. Everything is in Torah. So what can we learn this year as we renew the annual cycle of learning and living Torah? After many months of living with the pandemic and all of its challenges, it's become clear that we need to embrace the silver linings of our new normal. In other words, the positive and hopeful aspects of life. Life demonstrates this lesson very well. One looks at what's involved in living a Jewish life and says, look at all these rules and rituals there are to follow. It's just too much for me. While others look at living a Jewish life and say, look how meaningful it is. Make no mistake, this is our Red Sea moment. Like the Israelites of old, we need to decide whether to return to Egypt or move forward, even with the many uncertainties we face in the wilderness. To be sure, there are many situations where it's difficult to find a silver lining. There are tragedies and personal losses where emotions run deep and painful. But perhaps after some time has passed and we've reflected on our experiences, we can choose to see things in a new light, hopefully with a change in perspective that allows us to respond positively to life's challenges. Take this modern spin on a tale about Elijah the prophet. In the story, Elijah visits a man at a local racetrack and tells him to bet on a certain horse. At first, the man resists because this particular horse loses far more than it wins. But Elijah insists this horse will be the winner. So the man goes to the betting window, and the clerk laughs at him for betting on such an unlucky horse. And to show how silly the guy is, how silly this bet is, the cashier gives him 1,000,000-to-1 odds. The man puts down a small amount of money, $2 US, around 50 hryvnia, and sure enough, the horse wins. After the race, he walks up to the bettor's window to claim his prize, stuffing thousands of dollars into his pockets. But surprisingly, his face has a melancholy look. Someone sees him pocketing all this money and asks him why he's so sad. The man replies, look at this. The only time I ever won with 1,000,000-to-1 odds, and all I bet was a measly $2. The Torah reminds us, re'eh, look and see. We can look upon life's experiences with eyes of hope, gratitude, and faith, or we can look upon the same experiences with eyes of anguish and despair. Moses implores us, uvacharta v'chayim, choose life and blessing, every moment, every day, every week, and every year. All of us have the capacity to change our perspective and find silver linings. The choice is ours and ours alone. Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom, Shabbat shalom, Matt. Я розумію, що ви не бачили, що він казав, тому що, ну, коли я дивився, як це повинно бути на весь екран, але те, що було, ті, хто там сидять подалі, ви не бачили, але сподіваюся, це все буде в повторі у нас на Фейсбуці, у нас буде на сайті нашої громади, ви зможете прочитати дуже гарну проповідь, яку зробив рабай Мет. Berger. Now I would like to give a floor to Rabbi Adam Miller from Temple Shalom. Rabbi, your floor.
Thank you, Rabbi Duchovny, for inviting us to join you and your sacred community for this Shabbat service. Just a quick pause to say how beautiful it has been to share this Shabbat with you, with your community there in Kyiv, with Rabbi Berger and the community he has with Cantor Zoo, with all the beautiful soloists. It has truly been entertaining and powerful experience of Shabbat for all of us. We all learned during this pandemic the power of technology to keep us connected even at a time of physical distancing. What a beautiful and unique gift to be able to worship together when we are scattered across two continents, something that our parents and grandparents, much less our ancestors, could never have imagined. There is truly something sacred and beautiful about being able to create a kahila kadosha, a holy community, in this way. In a children's book of Jewish stories, Rabbi Mark Gelman imagines that throughout creation, there is a team of divine angels who are assisting God. They were the ones charged with designing each animal's shape and color, as well as the sounds they would make. So on the sixth day, when God said, "Let us create humanity in our image," the divine angels began to argue over the form for the first people. As they designed it, the angels fought over the color, with one starting to paint it yellow, another added brown, one splattered on black, and another white. A different group of divine beings disagreed over the sound, whether a person would roar like a bear or chatter like a monkey. And these arguments escalated to the point that the divine voice of God boomed from above, "Enough!" The angels all scattered in fear. And as they began to peek out from their hiding places, they heard a voice. "Excuse me, can I help?" Turning around, the angel saw a brown human with a smile upon her face. And then they heard another voice. "How about me?" And a third voice, "Or me?" And slowly a host of new people started to appear, each with a different color, yet all in the divine image and gifted with the power of speech. Every human being, every one of us, is created in the divine image, and we are all holy. There's a special spark that connects all of humanity, regardless of the color of our skin, where we live, or the languages that we speak. But tonight, gathering for Shabbat with each other across an ocean, we feel that there is an even deeper connection that exists between the members of these three congregations, a Jewish soul. There is something inside of us that we feel when we gather with others who share our collective memory. We sense a kinship with those who know our story and those who understand what it means to sit down at the Passover Seder and tell the story of our journey from servitude to freedom. We feel a special bond with those who recognize how it can be difficult to be strangers, to be different because of who we are. So may this experience of being together for a Shabbat of unity strengthen the connections that already exist between us. As we lit two candles tonight to start Shabbat, we watched the light from the two become one. In a similar way, may our communities that are shining from three different places now be linked together as one Jewish people. Vayar Elohim et kol asher asah, v'hine tov me'od. And God saw all that was created and said, "This is very good." Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom, Rabbi Adam Miller. I can promise that we three rabbis, at least Rabbi Matt and Rabbi Adams, I didn't see their sermons. I wrote my sermons before I received their sermons in order to translate into Ukrainian. But as you can see and hear, that we are talking about the same. Now it will be my turn, so I will be speaking in Ukrainian, and you will, those who are from the States, you will see the translation. And then you will understand what is the unity, because we are three rabbis, we are talking about our souls and about our unity to rise up our spirit and to rise up the collective memory. Я хочу вам сказати, що я отримав проповіді двох рабинів з Америки, але для того, щоб я не був під впливом цих проповідей, я свою написав першим. І ви зараз почуєте, і те, що ви зараз чули до мене, що ми всі кажемо про одне і те ж. Ми кажемо про єдність і про те, як Шабат і іудаїзм піднімає наш дух. Так що зараз ви можете дивитися на англійський переклад. У розділі Тори Брейшит зображено початок і оновлення. Свято того, хто ми є, і чому Бог створив нас. Висадивши посеред Едемського саду дерево знань і забороняючи їсти з нього, ми здивовані і спантеличені, ставлячи запитання: «А тепер, Ізраїлю, що від тебе вимагає вічний Бог твій?» Це цитата з книги «Повторення закону» Дворім. Залежно від того, як ми прочитали та зрозуміли цей вірш про дерево пізнань, воно або принесло покарання Адаму та Єві, оскільки вони більше не будуть жити в райському середовищі, або дерево буде життєво важливим кроком в інтелектуальному, емоційному, фізичному та духовному розвитку людства. Як нам у ці бурхливі часи пандемії відрізнити знання, від яких ми отримуємо користь, від того, що може завдати нам шкоди? Який спосіб наукових досліджень нам допоможе чи обтяжить? Яка економічна політика сприяє сталості, а яка регресії? Тора і єврейські мудреці, старі часи і сучасність вчать нас бути оптимістами і закликають нас пізнати велич наших дій, у межах яких ми живемо. Адже іудаїзм – це про вчинки. Іудаїзм – це про любов, єдність, підтримку та дружбу. І наш шабат єдності доводить цю сутність іудаїзму. Проект «Просимо, не забудьте нас» Темплю Шалом, який був започаткований Джуді і Говардом Пале, та подарунки, які ми отримуємо з 2007 року, надані Джуді Палей за підтримки членів Темплю Шалом та рабина Адама Міллера, були, є і будуть не тільки фінансовою підтримкою, але й орієнтиром для подальшого розвитку нашої надії Атікви. А фінансова підтримка членів релігійної громади Ахават Шалом та її чоловічого клубу, наша особиста дружба – все це один доказ дій Едварда Маркса, нинішнього президента Темплю, та і рабина Меттю Бергера. Наш шабат єдності вкорінений у дерево життя, знань та любові. Громада Темпля Шалома, Ахават Шалом та Атікви – це гілки цього дерева. І ми розуміємо, що все в нашому житті – це відображення зробленого нами вибору. Наш вибір через любов до ближнього, що створений за образом та подобою Бога. І цей вибір приводить нас до єдності нашого народу. Хай фрукти з дерева знань, які ми їмо, збагачують нас радістю, здоров'ям та розумінням. Хай ми продовжуємо куштувати численні плоди дерева Едемського саду і в захваті та щасті дізнаємося про те, що у наше життя приносить їх після смак. Всім нам шабат шалом. Дякую, колеги, за ваші проповіді. Я так розумію, що ви встигли прочитати переклад моєї на англійську. А ми зараз будемо закінчувати, ми вже підійшли к четвертій частині нашої літургії. Thank you, dear colleagues. I understand that you were able to read in English the translation of my sermon. I tried to do it very short, but it's usually not always goes as short as we would like in 3 minutes to put our words. And now we came to the fourth part of our Shabbat liturgy, Aleinu Leshabach. Let us glorify the name of God, and please rise in body and in spirit.
Aleinu leshabeach l'adon hakol, latet gdolal yotzer breishit, shelo asan kegoyei aratzot, velo samanu. כמשפחות האדמה שלא שם חלקנו כהם וגורלנו ככל ההמון העם ואנחנו קוראים ומשתחווים ומודים לפני מלך מלכי המלאכים הקדוש ברוך הוא שגון את השמיים ויוסד הארץ ומושב יקרו בשמיים ממעל ושכינת וזו בגובי מרומים ואלוהינו עינות אמת מלכנו, אפס זולתו, ככתוב בתורתו, וידעת היום, וידעת היום, וחשבות אל לבביך, כי אדוני הוא האלוהים, בשמיים ממעל ועל הארץ ועל הארץ מתחת אין עוד ונאמר והיה אדוני למלך
І зараз ми прочитаємо молитву про здоров'я. Ми бажаємо скорішого одужання. Так, скорішого одужання Олександру Левіту. І якщо серед ваших рідних та знайомих є ті, то зараз хворіють і потребують нашої спільної молитви, ви зараз можете назвати їх імена. So now we are going to hear the prayer for health. We know that the COVID pandemic is around, that we have some members of our congregation who also have COVID. So we wish all of them a speedy recovery. And if you wish, you can name those people who are now ill and need our collective prayer for health. And I would like the American side to lead us in the prayer.
Yishebeherach avotenu mekor habrach
source of strength, who bless the ones before us. Help us find the courage to make our lives a blessing, and let us say Amen. Mishevera imotenu mekor habracha avotenu. Bless those in need of healing with Ruach Lema, the renewal of body, renewal of spirit, and let us say Amen.
At this International Day of Music, this is another tribute to Debbie Friedman, who is rooted in Kyiv. Her relatives left Ukraine at the beginning of last century. And this is a melody which was written by the great composer Debbie Friedman. Thank you, Rabbi Matt. And now is the time for the final memorial Kaddish. And just would like to recall that this week and the next week in Kyiv, we commemorate the 80th anniversary of Babi Yar tragedy. And this is why it's so important to recall the words of Elie Wiesel. Elie Wiesel wrote my favorite words, which I will find now. And he wrote that if humanity doesn't have a cure for cancer yet, if it is not yet mastering Mars, if it is still unable to defeat hunger and find new sources of energy, then it is only because those Jewish genius who were supposed to make all these discoveries were burnt in the ovens of Auschwitz, and I will add, and killed by bullets in Babi Yar in Kyiv. Якщо у людства немає ліків від раку, якщо воно ще не освоює Марс, якщо воно все ще не в змозі подолати голод і знайти нові джерела енергії, то це лише тому, що ті єврейські генії, які мали зробити всі ці відкриття, були спалені в печах Аушвіца, Освенцима та розстріляні у Бабиному Яру. And I would like to ask Rabbi Medberger to lead us in the memorial Kaddish.
Please join me. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabah. Biamadi vra hirute biamlich malhute, Bechayechon of Yomechon of Haye de Kobet Yisrael, Bagalavisman Karivi Nru Amen. Yehesh me rabba mevarach le alam ulame almaya, Yiparach viish tabach viit paar, viit ramam viit nase, viit adar viit alev viit alal, Shemedikudisha brihu, Laelam in kol birkata vashirata, Tushbekata vanechemata. Da'amiran, bi'amavi imru, amen. Yehesh lama rabba min shemaya v'chayim, aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen. Osei shalom b'mamav, u'yasei shalom, aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru, amen.
And please be seated. And I would like again to ask our cantorial soloist Michael Urisman to introduce his melody for Adon Olam. This is an anthem not only for the unity, this is an anthem of the memory of those generations who came before us and for us and for those who will come after us. Adon Olam, melody by Michael Weissman. Ви поняли? Зрозуміли?
Adon Olam, Hashem Alach, Beterem Kol Yitzir Nivra, Adon Olam, Leheit Nasa, Vechefzo Kol, Azai Mere, Shemo Nikra, Adon Olam, Ve'ahari, Kiklot Ha'akol, Levado imloch nora vehu haya vehu ove vehu yihye v'tifara Adon Olam Hashem Alam Beterem Kol Yitzir Nivra Adon Olam Leheit Nasa Bechetzo Kol Chai Melech Shemo Nikra Adon Olam Ve'arik Kvot Ha'akol Levado Yilot Nora
Thank you, Michael. And as an exclamation mark, Leo and Anna will lead us in Alleluia, written by Cohen. Alleluia.
I've heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, and baffled kick, composing hallelujah. 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 Your faith was strong, but you needed a proof. You saw her bathing on a roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. She tied you to a kitchen chair, she broke your throne, and she cut your hair. Hallelujah.
Thank you. You're great. Давайте поаплодуємо. Just to tell you that Anna is only 17. I would like to thank all of you. First of all, I would like to thank my friend Edward Marx for his wonderful idea, and Anita, who is just behind him, backing him, for a wonderful idea to do a Shabbat of Unity. And I would like to thank both my colleagues, Rabbi Matt Berger and Adam Miller, for taking participation in the services and supporting such a wonderful idea. Thank you, Cantor Dona. And thank you also, Cantorial Soloist from Atikva Congregation. And this is what is a unity. This is why we are created, to give a hug, to give a smile, to enjoy Shabbat, and to be a real human being, because Talmud is saying, love God in humans. And this is what we are doing, and this is why it is so important for us to do this Shabbat of Unity and to continue our friendship and connections. Thank you. If you would like to say final remarks, please, from American side.
I just want to say it's just been such a blessing to share this with you. Really, we've created a magical moment here, and wonderful to hear all of the melodies, some of which are new to me and beautiful as well. So I hope and pray that all of us will go from strength to strength.
Thank you. We can share the musical notes, and you will have, and you can think the melodies, and the melody, the music will unite us through the ocean.
Rabbi
well.
Miller, unfortunately, is having some computer difficulties, but he asked me to say thank you for inviting us to End Temple Shalom to be a part of this special service, and wishing you all a Shabbat Shalom.
Thank you so much for your wonderful voice and participation in our service. Thank you, Rabbi Adam. We saw your greetings, and thank you to all who wrote and is still writing the greetings on the chat line. Shabbat Shalom, enjoy your day, enjoy Shabbat, and we will continue here with the Kiddush in Kyiv and some announcements. Thank you. And I hope it's only beginning, like we have a Torah portion beginning. So it's a beginning of our joint services. Who knows? Maybe we'll come together in one place, not virtually, but physically, and we'll rise up our spirit and souls. Shabbat Shalom to all of you. Bye. По-перше, хочу вибачитись за те, що більшу частину я проводив англійською мовою, але я розумію, що ви вже все знаєте. Ви відчуваєте, що я хочу сказати. Навіть якщо ваша англійська мова не така вже гарна, але ви відчуваєте це відчуття єдності, нас і поєднувало з тими, хто зараз з нами там в Сполучених Штатах Америки. Ця служба, ми її записали, вона буде у нас на сайті, ви знову і знову можете послухати і голоси Анни, і Давида Ахтирського, і Майкла Урісмана, і музичне супроводження Лео, і послухати Кантора Донну, яка співала, і послухати співаючого рабина Меттю Бергера з Сполучених Штатів. Хочу вам сказати, що завтра ми